Hello, everybody. We've got some Motown tonight to kick things off. We're here. We're live. We're live at 8 o'clock as per usual. It's Wednesday. We're here to have some fun. Oh, so we've got some chat messages already. Good evening, Tolrix. Good evening, Ross. Has something happened with Land Raiders that I haven't heard about? Something beyond the sad point drop that doesn't even let you get an extra intercessor into your army? No, Michael, nothing's happened with Land Raiders that you've not heard about, other than the fact that Land Raiders are amazing and everybody should love them more. And we should all strive to have at least three in our armies. Good evening, Ian. Bonjour to you, Alice. Hello, DeBaconator. Curious question, what are those headphones? These headphones are AKG K240 Studios. That's what they are. And they're very nice. They have an incredibly long cord, which is perfect for when you're messing about at home. Good evening, Russ. I hope you are all doing really well today. Oh, I've got the dancing shoes on. I really like these headphones. I used to obsess over the Sennheiser HD205s, and then they broke, and then they got discontinued. And that was awful, because the Sennheiser HD205s were beautiful headphones, and they only cost 50 quid. But they were just, they were so much better than, you know, anything else that I'd ever experienced until that point. And they had a cool little movable head ear cup. You just can't find them anywhere because they've been discontinued. It's Warhipster Wednesday. But with three Land Raiders, there is no room for George the Dreadnought and the Grav Tank. No, I know, Dolrix. That's why in all of my fluffy games, Land Raiders will be there. In the real spice, there will be George the Dreadnought. Also, you could fit it in. You just wouldn't be able to fit much else in. Good evening, sir. What's the Land Raider meta? Jim, the Land Raider meta is everybody... If everybody started taking Land Raiders, Warhammer 40,000 would be a much better game. That's the Land Raider meta. The Land Raider is going to become a symbol on the Warhipster channel of good feelings and good times. If I see Land Raiders out there, it makes my heart ever so happy. And yes, that's the Land Raider meta we're trying to start. That is what we're trying to do. That is what we're going to do. It's going to be amazing. We're going to be building a Land Raider later today. We're going to be building a Land Raider Excelsior. But it's not going to be the full, with the grav. Type thing, because it's going to be my venerable Land Raider for my custodies, is what it's going to be. We're going to do a couple of little, just leave a couple of the details off, but we're going to be building a Land Raider Excelsior. Is a custodies Land Raider different from a marine one? Other than being venerable, no. I'm pretty sure that means every player should have a keeper of secrets. I mean, yeah, they should. Every player should have a keeper of secrets, because the keeper of secrets is a great model. And you can see how to paint a Creeper of Secrets here on the channel. But, yes. Before we do anything else... has it crashed? Maybe it's because I'm dancing too much. I hope it hasn't crashed. Is it alright for everybody? Hello, Paul. Good evening, Alex. Awesome. So yes, last week's stream was exceptionally generous. It was exceptionally generous. You guys were amazing. You made me weep in public. That's what happened. So, All of the stuff has arrived.
It has arrived in a mighty box.
Now, I do receive a lot of mighty boxes. This is the mighty box. Look at that. So, is it just Land Raiders? It's not just Land Raiders, James. So, I've cut open the box, but I've not really looked inside at the majority of the stuff because I was excited. I wanted to show you guys what the amazing generosity of this community was able to pull together for me, for my custodies, and for the incoming White Scars. Yes, because that's what I did. We bought this black box. This is the only thing. It's the only thing that we bought. No, it's not. This black box. And I wanted to open this black box live. Live. Nice music. How's it going? I'm very well, thank you. We're having a Motown moment. Because I'm feeling bouncy. Now, typically, these are supposed to have a sticker on the front telling you exactly what it is. You know, this one doesn't. But we do have this black box, this unmarked black box, who should be... Oh, yes, look, there he is. Jagatai Khan. The Primarch of the White Scars Legion. Oh, baby. Look at that. Look at that. I mean, that is some very, very simple instructions right there. Look at that. It's a bit... I'm hoping there's slightly more in-depth instructions than that. Normally they come with like a big, full... page worth. No, we just got the inspected by. Yeah, that's it. That is it. I love this about Forge World instructions where it just goes, just put the parts on the model and it'll be all good. You know, you'll have a good time. But yes, there he is. Jagatai Khan, the Primarch of the White Scars. But we're not done there, folks. No. Of course we're not. That was, I know a lot of people have want a video on him. This will go with our Sanguinius, our Horus, and our Lionel Johnson, and a Magnus the Red, who is over there, yet to be built. But I'll do them as a partner. White Scars and Thousand Suns Primarchs. Magnus the Red and Jagatai Khan. That'll be a week. Step one, draw a circle. Step two, draw the rest of the L. Excellent. So yes, there we go. There's the Khan. What we also have here in this box, some Legio Custodes Sagittarum Guard. The upgrade set for them. Yes, we do. Fulgrim, hopefully. Unfortunately, not at this point, plan. But we will eventually. What we also have is... the Legio Custodes, Telamon Dreadnought, Acestus. Yeah, so you know what that means, don't you? That means we also have the Accelerator Culverin. And we also have the Arachnus Storm Cannon. That means we also have a Telamon Dreadnought. Which means we also have a Galatas Dreadnought. And we also have a Caladius Grav Tank Annihilator. We have a transfer sheet. And now you can't see anything on the stream. There we go. There we go. Oh, and who can forget, of course, the all-important Pot of Retributor Armor. That's the most important part of this whole enterprise. Because without it, the whole thing doesn't get done. But yes. There's all of our toys that the generous, amazing community were able to fund last week, and bought for me and made me cry on stream. So I want to thank you all again for that. Videos for all of this stuff will be coming in the future. Good evening, Mark. Good evening to you, sir. There we go. There is the haul from last week. And honestly, you broke me a little bit. And there is a Caladius, the other one, the Achilles. There's an Achilles on the way. So we will have pretty much everything in the Custodes range apart from a couple of bits, which is very exciting. And there will be videos for all of it, of course. Big props on the Njalvid, homie. Oh, thanks very much. That one is available early for Patreon users and YouTube members. Njal Stormcaller. What body are you planning on for the Sagittarum Guard? So what I'm planning to do is, because I've got this theme for my troops where I'm going to use Custodians as per normal, with a Warden as the leader. So basically what I'm going to do is the Sagittarium, it's going to be four normal Custodians with a Warden as the leader for the group. That'll be how I distinguish a squad leader. They don't have them, but for me it just looks really quite nice. I finished actually three of those Custodians, they're over there. I might get them a little bit later on, but it's basically two normal Custodian guard with spears, with a Warden with a spear, and it makes them look quite impressive. Well, I really like the look of it, so that's what I'm going to be doing with the Sagittarium, and for all of the troops going forward. That's the plan, at least. Forge World stuff within a week must be nice. No, I know. It's that UK shipping, you see. It's very useful. Very, very useful indeed. Now, as I mentioned, it's Land Raider. It's Land Raider time, baby. Now, I have had in my pile of shame for a long time this. I've had this. The Space Marine HQ Command Tanks. So this is the Land Raider that I'm going to be building. So basically, the Grav isn't going to be in it. The Space Marine isn't going to be in it. But the rest of it pretty much will be. And then I might stick some Custodian shields and bits of the Vexillus on it as well, just to give it even more bling. So it's going to be cool. I've got loads of spare bits from all the Custodian stuff that I've got. And we have a huge box of sprues just here. So that's a Land Raider sprue. That's a Land Raider sprue. That is a Land Raider sprue. That's a Land Raider sprue. That's a Land Raider sprue. There's a lot of Land Raider sprues. That's the upgrade kit for the command vehicle. And there's the instructions. This box, actually, I'll start tonight off with a leg on a Custodian. Russ, that's very kind of you. Thank you very much for the two. That's very, very kind of you. Thank you. The command tanks come with this transfer sheet, which might be worth looking into. If anyone ever looks at getting some really awesome transfers. Because these transfers are pretty cool. I really like these ones, for example. The Blood Angels ones are nice too. Like, stand there, that little bit just there. But yeah, box is really nice. Big fan of that. Right. Something's going funny with my computer. Let me just check something. 1 second, team. Uh, being a butt. Yeah, I thought that's what was happening. I think if I maybe... No Crimson Fists on that decal sheet, though. No, unfortunately not, Jack. Good evening, Chris. Land Raiders ho. Yes, this is the Land Raider we are building. Land Raider seems like a good thing to use your fancy airbrush on. Maybe. Maybe. I'll see how I feel. I might do it all with a brush, though, you know, because I'm a mad lad. I've got some interesting plans, I think. With it to do some cool stuff. Now my computer sorted itself out. There we go. Yes, Rez. Excelsior! Got to go now. Can't withstand the Land Raider's majesty. James. Well, the Land Raider is not for everyone. But the Land Raider is a legend of our time. I've been looking at the kit's instructions all day. And I've just been like, yeah, no, this, look. It's a normal Land Raider up until this point. And then it's a case of, like, attach your bits and bobs as you like. So we're going to be building this today. What we're going to be doing. It's going to be a good time. Ultramar forever. Yes. It's a lot of sprues for one tank, right? Let's put this here so that I can actually see it. So yeah, what is everybody working on tonight? I hope everyone's having a lovely time out there and is excited by the prospect of tonight. Right. We start with this piece? Yes, we do. A Land Raider is for life, not just for crusading. You are so right, Flyin. Right, first bit. Here we go. Land Raider. Boom! Land Raider meta just started, everybody. I need somebody to draw a cartoon of me riding in a Land Raider with a gigantic paintbrush. I'm refreshing Battlescribe because I don't want to do maths, which is worrying because I work for a bank. Is this around points changes that haven't been updated in it yet? Oh, I need a bit. I need a small bit. Where is the small bit? We're on old sprues here. Is it that one? Yes. Painting a war bus. I trust that needs no explanation. Nope, no explanation required, Ross. I would like a Land Raider for my Deathwing, just for the rule of cool. Yeah, and we have ITT. Yes, we do have ITT. And I'm sat frantically trying to figure out what I'm going to take to it with the demons. Land Raider pick with an airbrush cannon and Gracia spray as flamers. Yes, that's exactly it. That's exactly the one. That's what I need. I need someone to draw that for me. Don't see this very often. Overflash. I'm genuinely contemplating picking up Dexessa and Sinessa for the ITT so that I can run a triple Keeper of Secrets list. But the question is whether or not they're
is whether or not they are legit as Keeper of Secrets models, which I don't know for sure. They're not Keeper of Secrets models, and their bases are slightly bigger, so I might email the tournament organisers and say, is this okay? If it is, then I might take it. Well, where does this bit go? Oh, it goes there. Taking pretty much my Goonhammer list, just no Termies. That makes sense. That makes sense. It's a good list. You only had one. Did you only have one Grandmaster in that one, Rich? Because you'll only be able to take one now. With the new chapter approved rules. Currently just casually assembling a custodian Terminator. Not sure how I got here. I kind of feel like doing a Black Parade custody. I like it. Rez, you are a trendsetter. Of course you are. That's how I've always viewed you. Right, we need to do the engine block now. Where is that? There it is. That's why you're going to see so many Demons players at... the ITT. Everyone's going to be like, oh my god, man, we saw you on Tabletop Tactics. We saw how badly you performed with that in the league game. So we thought, hey, let's all take Demons and prove Josh wrong about how good they are. And I'm like, haha, my insipidness has paid off. You are now all fully corrupted by Slaanesh and Bellicor. Yeah, basically. I don't know if I'm going to be the wild card outfit that takes the shittest list. Probably am, because I think all of the rest of the team are taking 9th edition codexes. And I'm the only one with the 8th one. The 8th ed one. I'm pretty certain. Unless Adam takes Tyranids. I'm not sure what he's going to take. But... but yeah, I'm either gonna just try and cobble something together with what I've got with the demons, something that will be competitive and try and keep up, but also something that will be fun for me, or I'm gonna buy something to make it a little bit more spicy, and that's either gonna be some Beasts of Nurgle, or it's gonna be another Keeper of Secrets. Maybe I could take 3 Keepers and a Lord of Change and Bellicor. So I am playing Demon Knights. The problem is I've got a funny feeling that I'm going to end up facing Tau Hammerheads, which will womp a greater demon quite easily, or at least make them really bad. So that's why I'm like, oh, I'd love to take the Great Unclean one, but I also don't want to, my very first day at Game of the Weekend, be Josh, you'll take the Tau player, and then I look across and I see 3 Hammerheads that just basically, because the Great Unclean one has 18 wounds, they just, you know, hit him with 3 rail guns, and I have to suddenly disgustingly resilient that many wounds, which is a very real possibility. Right, engine block. That looks pretty good to me. So yeah, it's a funny one. Whereas I think Beasts of Nurgle are something that would be really good in the Demon's Army. I mean, they're really good anyway. I just think in my current army, I think like a unit of like 3 or 4 of them with the Great Unclean one with the bell, and you just use that as like an anchor point for the army that sits either in the middle or on the backfield objective. Generally on the middle one. That frees up a lot of like stuff for like the the Fiends of Slaanesh to be able to go and do work, and same for like the Screamers and things. I didn't realize tonight was going to be a full, I was going to go off on a diatribe about demons, but there we are. We're talking about custodians and the Land Raider meta. I was hoping Adam would be here to be annoyed. Okay, we put this to one side for the moment. So much plastic. Okay, so I do need the floor. There we go. So that's the thing that I'll need. Got the engine block, got the roof. Don't need that or that. What I do need is the front. The opening ramp at the front. Yep, that bit. And this bit. And then I need the left-hand side? Is that it? Yes. So... not that bit. The right-hand side, that's what I need. This is one of those sets of instructions that doesn't have any numbers, so you have to, you have to be able to look at it. Right. So that's that bit. That bit's going to go in there like that. That's going to go in there, allegedly. Yes. That's then going to go in there. Interior painting. I will not be painting the interior. My life is too short for that. And that can go, that goes on there. Is that right? It doesn't line up, does it? No. There is a lip. Okay, good. Alright. Let's do some cleaning. Hello, Fred. How are you, buddy? You say it's okay because Alex is going to be there, Rich. He's taking probably the most powerful army that we as a group will have. Albeit with the non-meta choices. He should be good for three to five wins. On that strength of that alone. And if he isn't smashing that amount of wins, he needs to hand in his custodian's badge. He's no longer allowed to be part of the 10,000. Alright, and then that's going to go on there. Clean this one off, and then we can do all of it at once, rather than the doors. They don't need to go in just yet. How's the army coming along? It's coming, Fred. All of the stuff has arrived. From last week. You kind people. I unboxed it at the beginning of this stream. Which was really cool. I've painted 3 custodians since then. And Valdor. I painted Valdor at the time of last week's stream. So I've painted 3 more of them. But I had to finish a. Arm slip. I had to finish my Stormcast army for a weekend of Age of Sigmar this weekend coming up. What should your next purchase for your Astra Militarum be? That's an excellent question, Jake. Jack, sorry, not Jake. What have you got already? Is the question. I don't think you can go much wrong with guard tanks. Lehman Russ are obviously a very good option, as you said. Be after I get 2 more Lehman Russes. It's tough because they're not far away from having a new book, presumably. It'll be this year. It'll be in the next six to 7 months, one would assume. So it's hard to know exactly. I personally really like the Death Strike. It's not very good in games, but it's really cool. Although I do believe one of the new Vigilist books or something, one of the new Armies of Renown, gave a buff to the Deathstrike. Oh, got a bit of schmutz on here, which could do with coming off. Get off. There we go. 3 units of troopers, Gaunt's Ghosts, 3 Russes, and a Hydra. Ah, very nice. So Bulgrin are always a good shout if you're looking to play sort of slightly more competitive games. Bulgrin are pretty good at holding objectives. They're very tough, particularly with the Invuln shield, I want to say, or the 2+. I think either's a good shout. I think you can have a mix of them as well. Hello, Hunter SWC. I am very well. How are you? Basilisks are always a good option as well, Jack. Add that long-range artillery for the guard. This person singing to me. I mean, the Basilisk is great. You are right, but the Baneblade is the king. Of the tanks. Everyone knows I love Baneblades. Once the Land Raider meta's done with, it'll be the Baneblade meta, I bet you. The Land Raider meta is not a thing. Well, no, the Land Raider meta, as I was explaining at the beginning, is a thing. It is a badge of happiness for all hobbyists everywhere. And I think that the channel of Warhipster has got the power to change the face of competitive wargaming forever. Like, even I know Rich is even thinking about a teleporting Grey Knights Land Raider. He's not. Bob Ross is a Land Raider. Sadly not. This is going to be annoying, isn't it? So I think the right thing to do here is to get the other side. What's the AOS equivalent of a Land Raider? Oh, that would be a steam tank, surely. Unless they are an actual direct meta choice at the moment, in which case, then they're not a Land Raider equivalent. I have a real big fondness for things like the Hellblaster volley gun and stuff like that. Like those things. I don't know if they're any good currently, but for me they would earn huge points with me if they were present in all Cities of Sigmar and Order armies. This is too much glue to have in the open air at once. There we go. Glue is good. Very glue. Such glue, much wow. The shell of the Land Raider. It begins. That's page one done, baby. Mr. Jimothy 1215, banging tunes. Thank you, Mr. Jimothy. I feel like this is Land Raider building music. That's why I was flicking through the playlist earlier and I was like, yeah, this is the one. This is what a Land Raider pilot would listen to, because a Land Raider pilot has nothing to fear. So, you know, travelling across the war-torn battlefields of the 41st millennium. Do 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 do. I'm just gonna keep the door shut. There's no point in having them open. Right, we need the interior wall.
Where is it? There it is.
Aha. Yeah, Emperor Bobblehead on the dash. Put a speaker in the Land Raider to play these songs in your games. I have a friend AJ who has done that, I think. Ever heard about our Lord and Saver Saxo Marine? No? Oh. The Land Raider is a perfect orc tank. The Land Raider is a perfect tank for everyone, and everybody should use one. I think if I get this Land Raider finished before team tournament, I should be allowed to take custodies rather than Alex. I don't think this is gonna need gluing. Nope, definitely not gonna need gluing. Very cool. Wicked cool. And then that's gonna go over there. Oh man, they're so cool.
I love these things so much.
I want to see the list that is nothing but Dreadnoughts and Land Raiders. Well, Jimothy, you can do it. You would need to be Blood Angels. Everyone should buy a Land Raider for their armies, not sponsored by Games Workshop. I wish I was sponsored by Games Workshop, Easy Peasy Lemon Squeezy. I wish I was. I'm telling you this because Land Raiders are awesome. They are my favorite of the tanks. Right, this goes in here. Maybe this is how I get sponsored by Games Workshop, is there's a 400% increase in the sale of Land Raiders because of Warhipster. If they had a customer survey option when buying, when you check out, and people said, I'm here because the Warhipster told me that Land Raiders are awesome and that he loves Land Raiders, I think I might get that sponsorship, that sweet, sweet, sweet partnership. Ah, so Blood Angels can take a character Dreadnought, so you can take a Librarian Dreadnought as your HQ. You could then, these are now 20 points cheaper, I believe, across everyone. Maybe just the custodians, but they're let's say they're 260 points. Three of these, plus a Blood Angels Dreadnought, that's 1,000 points. Then you can just fill out the other, like, side of it with more Blood Angels Dreadnoughts or Blood Angels Land Raiders. But you definitely, it would just be Land Raiders and Dreadnoughts. Everyone else, I think Iron Hands could do it as well with a character Dreadnought. Or the Chaplain Venerable Dreadnought, but I think he's been legends'd. You need a character Dreadnought to be able to run it as a fully mechanized Dreadnought and Land Raider list. Otherwise, you can just take one guy who sits in the Land Raider. So like in the Custodes list, for example, you could take something like, or Crimson Fists, can take Pedro and put him in a Land Raider and then just fill out the rest of it with Land Raiders. Because there's three different Land Raider patterns. You've got the Land Raider, you've got the Land Raider Redeemer, and the Land Raider Crusader. Which means you can, in theory, take nine, because that's nine Land Raiders, right? You won't be able to fit nine into a list, but you could take nine. I really like them. Is Sergeant Cronus a HQ? He is, I believe, but I don't think he can be put in a Land Raider. Unfortunately. I think he can only go in like a Rhino chassis, so like a Predator, a Whirlwind. Have you ever thought about doing a video where you purposely make common contrast painting mistakes on a model and then show how you would go about fixing the mistakes? I have thought about doing that, Mr. Noob. And it's very much on my mind of something that I'm going to do across this year. So we're going to be doing a slight... we're going to be adding more content this year. So I'm hoping to go for a time where there will be sort of a video or a stream across 5 days of the week. And one of those is the kind of Friday thing where I will start adding more of that type of content. The basics and stuff like when people ask me what my setup is or what my brushes are or all that kind of thing, to make videos about that kind of thing. So yeah, I've got a load of stuff filmed for stuff like that. It was just finding the time to do it. This year we're going to be doing it. So there's going to be all kinds of different kind of the basics and some more advanced technique specific videos type thing. That stuff is all coming. Because I should have the time to do it this year. Last year I just didn't. Last year got away from me in a big way. That video is coming. There you go. Good evening, Mr. Tabletop Ready. Looks like Cronus can go in a Land Raider. Well, there you go. You can take an Ultramarines list. That's not a Crimson Fists army, though, Mr. Harkness. No, sir. It's a non-character Land Raider, but it does benefit from having a character in it. I can't remember which one it is. It's one from Forge World. It's not the Command Land Raider, because that's what this is. But there's one where if you have a HQ in it, you generate a command point or something at all times, which is pretty dope. Right, this folding mechanism, does it need to be put in? What does it do? I don't think that does need to go in, because I've glued it. Paint the dank with brush or airbrush? I don't know, I haven't decided yet, Vale. Because it's a Custodes Land Raider, I'm probably going to spray it with a metallic paint. But what I might do is I might spray it with Rune Lord Brass and then layer over it with Retributor Armor. Now, whether that goes through an airbrush or whether that goes over a brush, I haven't decided yet. I have no idea what sprue this just came off of. Yes, R6. Right, so this is the right hand one. I want him to be a nice, a very blingy, but very blingy warm Land Raider. Yeah, that goes on that side. Have I got any terrain bids? Yeah, I have. With the Land Raiders, don't forget the Thunderhawk gunship and the Astraeus. See, that's the thing. It would be to get a Thunderhawk transporter where you'll be able to give your Land Raider something to ride in. I've got one terrain bid. Oh, I've got two, actually. I've got the Orc terrain from Kill Team. Warzone Chana? No, not Chana. Whatever it was. The Orc Commandos box set. So there's that. There's the Orc terrain. Scrap terrain, or whatever it's called. And I've got the Azerite Ruins. There's more stuff I want to do. Like, for example, I want to do some sculpting. Do a lot more, make some... I had this idea actually last night. You know, like, when you buy electronics, you get those big things of polystyrene. I want to use one of those as a mold, fill it with, some modeling compound or whatever, break it out, and then just use a hammer to bash it to make, like, a ruined readout or, wall or something, or, like, a big old ruined bunker type thing, like, huge, like, centerpiece terrain, that type of thing. Just finding the right polystyrene and whether or not it'll actually work as a mold. I don't know yet. Are the custodes you are doing for your own personal collection, or are they a commission? They are for me and me alone, Tommy. They are one of my... Oh, there's a dead sprue. That's nice. They're for me and me alone, for my personal collection. This is one of the four armies I hope to do this year. I hope to have a custodes army, a Tau army. I've done my Stormcast, but that wasn't on the list. I'm hoping to do, at the tail end of this year, Slaves to Darkness, and also to do maybe the Fire Slayers or the Sylvaneth, one of those two armies. I have an Alariel that is begging for me to paint. No, one of the main things about this Custodes army that made it all possible was I posted a picture of the old Custodes army I had on Instagram, saying I think I'm going to strip this because I'm a much better painter now than I was when I finished this army off. And the lovely Hellstorm Mikey sent me a message saying, "Don't strip it. I'll buy it. Well, I'll have it off you, and I'll just send you new kits." So you can just go again. Saves a job. And I was like, yeah, that sounds good to me. So I sent him my custodies, and he sent me new versions of everything. So it's an opportunity for me to get a really nice, fully contrast plus painted army from the ground up in my new style of painting with the custodies, which I'm really excited by. Look at it, it's taking shape. Look at how big it is! Sylvaneth, oh man, your Kurnoth Hunters were mwah! That was some serious gorgeousness there, homeboy. One Shield Captain, 3 Land Raiders, 2 Cladius Grav Tanks, 1 Telemann, and an Ares Gunship. Ha ha! That is an amazing 3 Land Raiders. I love you, Mr. Jimothy. What, is the Shield Captain on a bike? Because I feel like he has to be. To keep up with this much martial destructive power. Are you planning to make a painting guide for the Land Raider? I am going to make a painting guide for the Land Raider, yes. Look at it! I'm giddy. It's so lovely. I love you, Land Raider. Ah yes, tracks. Yes. That's the bit I forgot. The Breaker boss. Yeah, I do have some ideas on how to do that. My recall from memory is that when looking at it, I was like, Griff Charger Grey will be very important here. But I need to sit and do it. I've got the Breaker boss. It's just finding the time. I am but one man with a lot of commission work and tutorials to make. Slot in there nicely. Right, I need piece number 2, which is this bit just here. If you leave it with me a second, Michael, I'll get the box out and have a look at it and tell you exactly what I would think I would do. Alright, let me just... Oh, I remember what you're supposed to do with these. Start with the bottom bit. L5. Come on now, Josh. You've built many of these tanks before. I've just got this image in my head of having, like, a couple of Palace grab attacks or a couple of Caladius accompanying this venerable Land Raider as it deposits off Trajan and some Terminators to wreck some serious face in the midst of a ravening horde of demons. My horde of demons. Start with L5. Yeah. And the Blade Champion. Hey, I was wondering, how do you come up with your recipes? Is it experience or are you like trying a lot of things? Hello, Emily. I'm very well, thank you. How are you? For me, it's... A lot of it is experience, Kataro. I've used the paints a lot, which is why I kind of generally know what I'm doing with them. Like, I know what the colours are and what they're going to do. And so I look at the Games Workshop photography quite a lot. And then I try and replicate it. The other thing that I do, and I've talked about this before, is... The other thing that I do is I will often look at what the recipes they use, Games Workshop use, and then convert them to contrast. Like, because they've got loads of information. Like, whenever they have a model, if you scroll down on the Games Workshop website, even if this is all you use it for, or you use the Citadel Paint app, but like, scroll down on the GW website, underneath each model, there's a little paint guide. It'll have things like the red, and it'll be like, this is how we recommend doing the red. Now, it might not be spot on, you know, and it's not always perfect what they recommend, but you can generally get a pretty good idea of what you should do from it. So like, whenever you see something say, oh, it's Mephiston red, that means you're doing Blood Angels red, for example. That's generally how I do it. That is going to go there like that. Destroying Skaven on Warhammer 2 at the moment. Hate the buggers. That is fair enough. When playing as the Empire, they might be the most annoying thing in the world. Constantly. We're all corrupted again, my lord. Oh, for crying out loud. Would you guys just stop eating the clearly diseased rat meat? I hated it so much. You hate superior Skaven? We must stab this. Bring in that ace. I will be priming Thangqual and Bone Ripper next week, Taro. Just so you know. Not far away from doing him now. I'm really excited as well, because I think I've figured out a pretty decent scheme for him. There was a bit of a phenomenon on my last campaign that I did single player with Total War. Where the Skaven kept walking over, blowing up my cities, and then immediately suing for peace. And I was like, you've got to be kidding, right? Like, are you being played by a human character who just really isn't getting the social cue here? Like, we'll blow it up and then be friends, yeah? No, we will not be friends. You have upset me for the last time, Skaven. I had plans of my own. Yeah, you should be able to. They're one of those Age of Sigmar armies that I would really like to see get, not a complete overhaul, but just like have a time in the sun. The Skaven. They're very classic. It's pretty dope to me. Good evening, Bartosz. Now we just need part number 6. I want 40k Skaven. That would be interesting. Yeah, I mean rules, I mean models wise. Just like, I feel like some of the stuff that they could do now with the way that they're making models, just like swarms of rats alone. The killer should be with me any day now. Oh, I'm very excited. Thank you so much for that, buddy. The rest of the stuff has arrived. As soon as that Achilles is here... Achilles? As soon as that Achilles is here... I will be preparing the Tupperware for the great bath of the resin. The great resin bath of 2022. We need more for the Horde. Loktar Ogar? No? Okay. I like the idea of, like, Skaven spies that are just bodies. Like, they're just robes full of rats with a human face in it. I would love some new shaven rules. That's an excellent typo. General's Handbook 2022. All people must be shaven. Alice, if you're still watching and you're still in the chat, I hope you're ready for the day when you come home and you go, hang on, where the hell has all the washing up liquid gone? And you just come up here and find me in an ecstatic, surrounded by these little top pots of Tupperware with slowly cleaning resin, sat cross-legged in my swimming trunks just being like, we're having a great time! Look at what the stream got me! Look at what Warhipster community got me, and now I'm building it! We have an enormous custodies army now! 55 models. If I didn't release two videos a week, I was thinking about doing a year of custodies. Just seeing like how many I could get done in a year. Could I do a tenth of the 10,000? I don't think I could. How long would it take to do the 10,000? Oh, it's coming together. Oh, lordy. And now we need to do the right-hand side. Okay, that's not a dead sprue yet. That'll be important for that one. Don't need that either. Do need this. R5. 1,000 of the 10,000. Yes. My year with 1,000 custodies. So if I painted 3 custodians a day, every day for a year, 9, that would be 1,000. be over 1,000 actually. Chewy, I have many new shiny toys. 10 minutes of airbrush timing, 20 minutes of cleaning. Is there a fifth army coming too? I mean, I might do. Land Raiders are the best, Joshua Maguire. I'm not telling you off. I'm just reading your name as it was presented to me. The Land Raider is a symbol of kinder times in Games Workshop, I feel. Mr. Maguire, if we all agreed right now, that as a community we were a little bit more Land Raider and a little less Drakari Succubus, everything would be fixed. Imagine that. Imagine that world. That's what I long for. The Land Raider is going to become the symbol of hope. The Land Raider is going to become the symbol of a simpler time. Exactly, exactly, Josh. Exactly. Whilst the Eldari and the Tau are just duking it out for most broken faction, everyone else quietly in the background just going, cool, we'll leave you to it. We're going to go and have fun with our Land Raiders. And they'll all be like, oh man, that looks cool. Can't we join in? And they'll be like, no. No, because you don't subscribe to the world of Land Raider, guys. You're not cool enough to be part of the world of Land Raider because you're too busy. You know, you're too much focusing on this ITC thing, like, you know? All we need, I guess one of the things we should also probably do is I'll try and message Mr. Siegler. I'll try and message Mr. Richard Siegler and ask him to win the next LVO using 3 Land Raiders. I'm fairly certain he could do it. And then you'll see it happen. It'll be a brave new dawn in Warhammer 40,000. Suddenly Land Raiders are everywhere and everyone's loving life. This rated for your custodies. It is. I know, Flyant, I know. It would be cheaper if it was... So this is the thing. If the Land Raider stopped being a web store only model, it would go out into the independents. And if it goes out into the independents, then it'll become cheaper again. But it remains a little bit more expensive at the moment because it's a web store model only product. So the only way to get it is from Games Workshop directly. So it is up to us brave few, to buy a Land Raider every once in a while. It's up to the... When we get to like 20,000 subscribers or like 100,000 subscribers and then I send everyone forth to buy Land Raiders, you'll see it'll happen. It'll become, hey, people really like the Land Raider. We should probably get that in more people's hands. And they'll be like, wait, well, where's all this surge in Land Raider popularity come from? And everyone will be like, dude, Warhipster, man. He saved Warhammer 40,000. He reminded all of us that it was important to be a little bit more Land Raider and a little less succubus. I do plan on doing some of the new tower. I've got a Darkstrider on the way. And they are my plan is to do sort of later this year, probably Q2 of the year, maybe in time for Into the Maelstrom with my friend Chris. We're gonna do lots of Tau planning this weekend, I imagine. But I might take Tau as well as he is to Into the Maelstrom in Nottingham. That was piece R2, wasn't it? Yes, it was. I've got an Eldari commission to get through first, but with time allowing, I might do the Tau or I'll take the Custodes. One of the two. If I take the Custodes, you know damn well what's going to be. Got the Tau book on the way with Darkstrider, and I've got a number of Tau models in stock, as it were. So how about succubuses and Land Raiders? Now that would be amazing. Chris N, I literally just tuned in and my PTSD is kicking off. I worked for GW back in the olden times when the Land Raider Crusader was released and it was a plastic and metal kit. Oh dear. You signed up for your first tournament the other day. Well, good luck, my friend. I hope you enjoy the experience. That's not right. That's going to be upside down.
Are you serious?
How weird. Embarrassing. Hello, Adam. Thank you, Fred. I just realized I was being a nincompoop. How are you, Adam? Are you excited to join the Land Raider meta? Do you know, Michael, I've only built like 3 Land Raiders in my time. And this one I will need the instructions for because I've got the upgrade kit for it. I've never built this one before. Because this is the Excelsior! We've been discussing it, Adam. We've been discussing why the Land Raider meta is important. And I've come to the conclusion, and I've said this a couple of times now, but if we as a community chose to be a little bit more Land Raider and a little less Drakari Succubus, don't you think maybe that Warhammer 40,000 would be a much nicer place? And I'm going to make it happen. I think there's a secret code with the tank tracks, like every 13th track is the Imperial Eagle. I've heard this as well. I could count them, I suppose. Oh, this is some sexy music. We're also going to message Richard Siegler and we're going to demand that he wins the LVO with some Land Raiders, and he'll go and do that for us, and then you'll all be laughing. I agree. You know what the Tau Railgun can't pop in one shot? A Land Raider. Indeed, it is a sexy music for a sexy tank. I agree. Definitely the right track. R8, R9, yeah. Aha. We're rapidly approaching putting the top on. Thank you, Michael. Why need vehicles when you can have Gazgul? Well, because it's a Land Raider, Kitaro. They can do that all they like, but they're ignoring their invuln saves. They'll never destroy the Land Raider. At least not the Land Raider of my heart. Right, we need to do the lights. And it is... Yes, George! George is here! The Lord himself, our Lord and Master, Mr. George Smith. The most generous man on the internet. We did. Everything has arrived. Yes, George. It's all here. Including... I'll do this again for those who've joined recently. I'll just pop this... this guy has also arrived. Which is very exciting. But everything is... Everything has arrived. Yes. We have an Achilles. No, we don't have Achilles yet. That's on its way. We have a Galatus, we have a Telamon, we have Sagittarum, we have Jagatai Khan, we have a Caladius, we have... I think that was it. Caladius, Telamon, Achilles,
Galatas, Sagittara,
and the Khan.
Do I prime myself with Grey Seer or Abaddon Black? I would always prime myself with Grey Seer. And then I would put Gilliman Flesh over my face. I would probably use a mixture of Wildwood and Black Templar for my beard. That's probably how I would do my face. And my hair. Listening while working. That day makes me smile, George. It's all here. It's all ready to go. We're just waiting for the Achilles to arrive. And then when it does, I'm going to get a big basin. I'm going to get all the Tupperware out. I'm going to do a big washing party. Might even do that on stream. That would be my hot tub meta. I'll do it next year if that's what the community wants. I will paint 1,000 of the custodies. Right, I do need to clean this Land Raider off. I've already figured out what I need to do for the consistent basing as well. So I need to pick up a kit of a couple of the Sector Imperialis boxes. Because hopefully everything in the Custodes range is on a legitimate base, apart from the Caladia. So I need to get the large basing kit, and I need to get a box of the oval base, is the one where you get like all the different sizes of cavalry bases in it, and then we're good to go on all the basing. So I just need to pick that up as well, which I might try and get this weekend at Warhammer World, if they've got it in stock, because I've done everything else on Sector Imperialis, and I would want to keep that the same on the vehicles, and that will just hopefully just slot in there like that, and then we'll have to hold it down for a bit. But I do need to glue the lights in. Okay, why is it parting over here? Something funny's happened here. It's the Drex. Of course it is. Not quite in as well. Yeah, no, that is in. Right. Let's glue the lights in. Hot Tupperware meta. Yes! Should I do that on stream? We'll start. We'll Made my first kill team using orcs for the first time. I managed to get 4 sixes in a single roll of luck with my sniper. Let's just say things didn't go well with my foe's reaction. I imagine. Oh, that was mean. Of your dice. Not you. That's not your fault. 5:40. I've been a member for 5 months. That's very kind of you, sir. Is this going to be a red light Land Raider Custodes for Hire, like little neon sign on the sign saying available? No. It's going to be a bright gold Land Raider. We're going to hopefully make him a little bit more ornate, a little bit more worn out, a little bit warmer than perhaps the what Games Workshop box art entails.
Right, there we go. There's one light. Yeah, combat damage can look pretty good on it. What I'll probably do is add a little bit of like scuffing and dirt to like the around the track area. I don't want to damage it up too much though, because it's a custodian land raider, so it would reasonably to assume that it wouldn't spend, you know, they would want to fix it up pretty quickly, so it wouldn't just, you know, carry its battle scars for too long. And like the rest of my custodians are going to be fairly bright and clean as well, so I'll try and keep it fresh off the lot. Like I said though, I will probably build up a little bit of grime on the around the tracks areas, which will present an interesting challenge because contrast paint over the metal of the gold will make the dirt look metallic, which we don't want. Maybe some streaking grime. Maybe. Oh, thank you very much, Matthew. That's very kind of you. I really like making that video. I've got to tell you, it was a real debate. There was a lot of inner debate about whether or not I did this new army as Shadow Keepers. I decided not to in the end, because I really like the Golden Boys, the originals, the OGs. I did contemplate doing the Dread Host, but then it was just like, nah, the red is my true red and gold. That's what I'm all about. Right, this is doing something slightly weird at the back here. Why is it not sitting flush? Something is preventing its flushness. Something there. So what I might just do, solo watch for pain. It's pain. Let's just take top layer of this off. Yep, that was exactly it. I've got a bit of a mysterious gap over on this side as well. I'm not entirely sure what that's all about. Let's just squeeze it together. Cool. Let's put some glue on it. Lots of glue. So much glue. Right. What's this song? I'll be able to find out for you in just a moment. This song is called The Shame Is On You by The Devil's Sway. I need something heavy to just rest on it for a minute. Is this the George Army? It is the George Army, Ben. It is the army that YouTube built, basically. Yeah, YouTube paid for. Well, not YouTube themselves. My wonderful, lovely community all donated lots and lots and lots of money yet last week for me to buy more custodies and make more custodies stuff. May I see George?
Yes, Ben. George is...
George is here. There he is, in his sarcophagus, ready to be delivered. Deployed to planet Warhipster. What about George? Can I see them as well?
Yeah, if you like.
Uh, There's the other George. We have Tolrix here.
We have all of their weapons.
And we also have them. Sagittarum Guard upgrade sprue. Do you know what I haven't looked at yet? Is the thingies, what are they called? Transfer sheet. We'll do that in a minute. I'll have to get that out because I haven't actually had a look at it. Sacrilege, I know. Just waiting for this to kind of hopefully dry. If not, I'll just fill it with some green stuff. It's not the end of the world. It's nearly there. Slaying. It was incredibly generous. Last week's stream, if you go back and watch it, it was these guys were just amazing. This community is fantastic. I actually burst into tears. Well, not like, I didn't like sob, but like water came out of my face. That's what happened. It was also very wholesome. These are very pretty. That is a very pretty transfer street. How many of these do you think will work on the Land Raider? Pretty good. Just a little gap just here on this corner, so I'll probably just have to like fill that with just a little bit of liquid green stuff, but that's not gonna go together. Like I'd have to literally put like a 10 kilogram weight on it and just leave it, and I don't really want to do that. So that's a very nice transfer sheet. I feel like I could probably use this vehicle transfer. I could probably use this transfer sheet and the Blood Angels one I've got over there to make something very pretty with this Land Raider. Is that the George Mobile? It will be. George will ride in this. Or I believe it's the Ares that I can put a dreadnought in. So I feel like I should get George and Ares at some point in the future. For him to fly around in. I feel like that would be sprue goo. Yeah, people have said that to me before. I might pick some up just to put a little bit of it. Just, it's literally just in that little corner just there. And maybe just to put a little bit of it on. Actually, just put a little bit of glue. Screw clamp would help. I've never needed one before until now. Oh well, you live and learn, eh? Ooh. A bit too much excess glue there. Hello, Bruno.
Fun doom is here.
Right, what's it telling me to do now?
It is telling me to build the cool stuff.
Sit on it. No, I think I'm too heavy for it.
So, as previously discussed, we have a Land Raider Excelsior here. So, what we get is we get this cool thing. This bit. I like that because this upgrade sprue is new. This bit actually has numbers. The rest of it doesn't. Yeah. So what we get is we get this little awesomeness. So this bit now basically goes there, and then we get these little flags and stuff. It is the Warhammer World Land Raider. This is what's going to make it nice and venerable for my custodies. So that's going to go there, like that, and then it gets the cool doors as well. Let's put the doors in first. You get stuff like this little piece, which would make a really cool custody storm shield. Now I would glue it that way around, but they weren't at any of these.
Now I might build the Rhino Primaris as a Null Maiden Rhino as well. Just move that out of the way for a second. So that's a pretty cool door, right? Now I think I'll leave off these little bits here so I can put some of those transfers on. Make it look nice and custodies. You got bits to have a custody popping out on the top. I don't think so. I don't have a spare body. And yes, I'm going to glue the doors on the front and the guns on the back. You can. Like that. But I'm going to do it this way around. It does sound like Christmas music, doesn't it? It's Christmas music. Right, let's change to something else. Let's go for this. I'm gonna put the gun on the back there. I know it doesn't make any sense. You want guns on the front? Is that what you would prefer, guys? Fine. Fine, I'll do it. I'll do it your way. I don't want to be judged too much by everyone, you see, that's the problem. Guns on at the back. Guns on the front, sorry. To be honest, I'm not entirely fussed about where the guns go. That is some hardcore peer pressure. Oh no, wrong way around. Haha. There we go. Now we'll do this bit. Where's that gone? There we go. Guns on the back. Shut up. Ooh. This sounds like something The Weeknd would have made. Does anyone know what blades I need to get for the Citadel knife? Because I believe this is my last one. It's just occurred to me that eventually this one shall dull, and then I'll be stuck. Oh, thank you very much, Underdog. I am going back. There will be a third time. There will be a third meeting. I was trying to convince Lawrence yesterday that it would be okay if it would be okay for me to take my Stormdrake guards. I use a standing knife. Blades snap off rather than needing replacements. Ah, I see. Number 7 or number 2. Okay. I shall investigate. I know it's on my list of things to do, but you know, it's just one of those things that you're like, oh, I won't need to replace these for ages, or just get a new set for a long time. Ross. Gonna call it a night. Cheers all, and just remember, the true Land Raiders are the Land Raiders we Land Raided all along. Have a good one. I used to get my replacement blades from the doll shop in Lem. Did you now? Interesting. Just had this song. It was a bit too sad and sexy for me. There we go. Doesn't that look nice? Right, we've got a little radar dish as well. I don't know where it is though. 16. There it is. You think it would be on piece 15, wouldn't you? Aha.
Oh, baby, don't cry.
your world is hollow. So hollow. Yeah. Cause I can see it in your eyes. Oh, yeah. But there is no need for sorrow. Cause I will be with you every second of my
I nearly bought some blades the other day from Hobbycraft. Then I was like, oh, I don't know if these are actually the right size. Then that goes in there. Got to run, but I just wanted to drop in for a little bit. Looking forward to seeing all that upcoming Custodes goodness heading to the channel. It absolutely will be, George. All of it is coming to the channel. Every single one of those miniatures will be getting a video, and I'm very excited to do it. The blade itself might have a marking on it. It does. It has a number 11 on it, but I don't think that means anything because I think they've all got 11 on it. Oh no, that has an 11 on it. Yeah, it has an 11 on it. So does this just go on there? Is that what happens? Wasn't paying attention. Look at the instructions one moment. What are we saying? Yeah, it does. Just goes right there in the middle. Oh, 39 and 38. It's got some more cool little bits. Oh, that's the size I need. Okay, so I need an 11 size blade. And you're off, are you, Michael? Cool, thank you for hanging out. And thank you. Is that Land Raider going to raid the land? You bet it's going to raid the land. It's going to raid all the land from here to the end of land. Bit 38 as well. Thanks for hanging out, George and Michael. Thank you. And that's going to go there. as well. Here comes the fiddly bit, making sure that this is right in the middle. And also straight. That looks right to me. And then we need this bit to go here. Might do is I might put like a custodian shield here. No, won't go there. Look at this land raider. Thanks for hanging out, buddy. Another 24 hours at the hospital. Good luck. I hope it's okay. And I look forward to talking to you again once you're out the other side. And I salute you, sir, for all that you do. It's incredible work. I should do a 24-hour Warhammer stream at some point, shouldn't I? That should be a thing that we do. Do one of these sponsons and see how long that takes. It's 12:15 now, so we're already about 12 minutes longer than we normally go, but we'll do one of the sponsons. I'd very much like to take this Land Raider and all of the Forge World toys that you guys so very kindly picked up for me, or helped me pick up, I should say. I'd very much like to take this into the Maelstrom. I think that would be really cool. But if I don't get it done in time, 24-hour building and painting a whole army on stream. Yeah, something like that. Not building and painting, because I hate building and it takes me 4 million years to do it. But painting a whole army, that could be something that I could do in 24 hours. We could make a little challenge out of it, couldn't we? Try and raise some money for charity as well. That'd be something we could do. I don't know what it is about Laz Cannons. I do just love the profile of it. I really like this. It just evokes so many memories. One Laz Cannon. I'm a big fan of the Laz Cannon and the Heavy Bolter. That's arriving quite a way ahead of the schedule. I didn't think they were supposed to be out until March. The speed paints. I'll have to check with Adam. Because I've got to make all of those what it looks like speed paint the videos for all of you lovely people. Yeah, I was going to do a couple of Speed Paint Plus tutorials, probably for Space Marines, Dr. Mirage. Just to go with the contrast ones, just to compare them long side by side, as it were. See if it's possible. Because, you know, did all of those first founding chapters in contrast. I think it'd be cool to do it in speed paint as well. Present the two side by side and then people can make up their own minds. I like them. I think they're cool. I don't think they're going to replace they're not going to replace contrast paints for me. Just because there is more in the contrast range. But there is no reason why others shouldn't do their research. That happened with the graphics card. Oh, that's very cool. MSC, sorry. Which graphics card did you get? Yeah, that looks level to me. Do this twice. I will, just not right this second. We need the roof of it, which is this bit here. No, It must be these. That must be the heavy bolter one, which we're not going to use. Yeah, longer groove. Speed Paint plus Hero Quest is the plan. RTX 3070. Nice. I've been reading that about the 3090, which is on pre-order, or it's out now. Speaking of games, I hope you're all excited, because I am. I have a copy of Elden Ring on its way at the end of this month. I'm going to be streaming it. We're going to be doing some Elden Ring stuff. Because I'm very excited for that game. Does Elden Ring have Land Raiders, though? It doesn't have Land Raiders, unfortunately. If it did, it would be the best game of all times. Now, what I am expecting is Space Marine 2 to have a Land Raider. Which would be very cool. Indeed. There we go. And we're in. Do you have a favorite From Software game? I mean, Dark Souls 1 is probably my favorite. Yeah. I really enjoyed Bloodborne, though. Bloodborne was... Yeah, well, thinking about it, maybe Bloodborne was my favourite. Because Bloodborne, like, made me want to break my own thumbs. But I did it. And I did it all with no help from the internet either as well. I just went for it. I just went and enjoyed it. Had a great time. Just did everything I possibly could, and then I did a second playthrough of it, whereas Dark Souls I didn't. Dark Souls I was also really enjoying Sekiro Shadows Die Twice. The problem with it was that I had a massive break from it for ages, and then I didn't finish it. So I got as far as, I think I was about three quarters of the way through, and then I stopped playing it for a while because life just got very busy. And then when I went and picked it up again, I was like, nope, this is too hard. So, yeah. I'm very excited for Elden Ring, though. That's one I'm just going to sit and absorb and play and love and just get super into. Is this a 2 and a 3? 2 and a 3 on the bottom? It must be, yeah, because that's how...
3 and 3.
I'm very confused. Yeah, you put the 3 on the bottom and the 2 on the top. Yeah, that's right. So I've got the entire of the Dark Souls trilogy downstairs. I could go and do that. How big are you making your fourth army? How many points should she have? I like to start with 2,000, as the plan get to 2,000, and then just add stuff for options. Generally the sweet spot is around about 3,000. Because what inevitably happens is I'll buy an army, or I'll have an army, and I'll have a very clear idea of how I want to play it, and I'll build it and I'll paint it. And then I'll enjoy it the first time I use it, and then I'll want to use it in a slightly more competitive manner. So like the demons, for example, the whole point of that was to do Disciples of Bellicor, which I did do. I had it, and I played it once, and then I ended up buying a bunch more stuff for a tale of many Warhipsters, and that included all of the greater demons. Yeah, Emily, that sounds like a good idea. Some co-op Elden Ring. Riding around. Smashing up whatever the hell the stuff is. On horseback. Oh man, it's going to be so cool. I'm so excited. Right, so you do that, and then you glue it to the thing, to the door. Yes. To that thing. Yes. That's what we do. I always play all of the From Software games with the intention of doing it stupid, and I can never bring myself. So like Bloodborne, I was like, the second playthrough, I was like, yeah, I'm just going to use the biggest possible heavy sword. I'm going to get good at this. And then it's too hard. So I'm just like, no, go back to the thing I already knew. Speed. Naught but speed. Ben, man, are you sat playing with the Force? Because you know that's dangerous. It's very irresponsible, Ben. Oh yay, more swarms. Savick, this is going to be for my custodies. This is going to be a venerable land raider. You know, if I had all the money in the world, I would buy 3 Land Raiders for the Custodes, and I would buy 3 Land Raiders for my Blood Angels, and I would spend the next 6 weeks just making Land Raider videos for everyone. But I know that that's not what the internet and the world wants. And also, you know, we don't have to get it all right away. that. Yes. And then that should go in there. Like that. Oh, baby. Oh, it's land raiding. It's ready to raid the land once I put this little sight thing on top. Well, it's half ready to raid the land. Well, it's a third ready to raid the land. What I might do when Elden Ring comes is I might just play the first like hour by myself just to get acquainted with it, and then do the stream that same day. Although I suppose you guys would quite enjoy watching me die 3,000 times in a row, so actually no, I won't do that. I'll go in blind. Nice, hopefully it will blast your enemies apart. I hope so as well. It's going to be gold, Veil. It's going to be gold and red. Because, you know, that's cool. Literally just had this song, guys. Let's go this one. Right, let's get this gun on. Oh. Can you feel it? Can you feel the power of the Land Raider? Yes, the power, ultimate power. Rewrite your destiny. Oh. Land Raider, ready to raid the land. You leave my Land Raider alone with your tail rail guns, okay? You just stay over there. Why are you not gluing? Gonna have to put the glue on the gun itself. That'll do it. Yeah, try and fall off now. Yes, Ben, you just stay well away. You wait until the Land Raider gets a stratagem to ignore invulns and do flat damage 6. And cost 10 points. No. Leave it like that for the moment. What time is it? 10:30. Ooh, we're nearly there. We're nearly at the end. It's late. It's getting late. How much is left? One more las cannon sponson, the heavy bolter turret, and two thingies to go on the top. That's quite a lot. What's the Land Raider meta now? There isn't a Land Raider meta. The Land Raider meta is a meta that we are developing, Crimson Griffin. What we're doing is we're making a choice, or I'm making a choice, to be a lot more Land Raider and a lot more fun with my games of Warhammer 40,000. And also, I just think they're really cool, and they're my favourite tank in the whole of the game. So I wanted one. I want two more. Tom Kenish, been painting some zombies today using the Wilhelm miniatures technique of smearing random contrast paints onto a Monk mini, adding some contrast meaning and dabbing it off. They look revolting. Yeah, that's what I did on my Deadwalker zombies. I do actually have two Baal Predators that I could do as well. Now, what are the added benefits? I did say that if anyone brings a Land Raider to Warhipster Fest, they immediately get 10 points, I think I said. They immediately get 10 points for every game. I mean, they are the best tank in the whole of the game, Crimson Griffin. I don't know what your point is. It has four whole las cannons. Four whole ones. What we need is these two heavy bolters. We'll do this bit, and then we'll probably call it a night there. Heavy bolter and heavy bolter. It still does that little bit extra, and I don't think I'll finish it in the next half hour. I think it'll take me about an hour left to go. So I need that, and I need bit 32, I think. Well, I just need probably just need that, but we'll see. That 5-point swing at Warhipster Con will be enough. And I don't care if it's if it unbalances the game. Right, so we do that, and then we have a bit down here which might not fit on it, but we're about to find out. 33. It should fit though. To smooth those bits out. I did the Deadwalker zombies as part of Curse City, along with the Olfen Watch, corpse bats and rats. I think that's useful for Soulblight Gravelords. Gravelords fans. The new army is the Custodes. Lithi. Yeah, tanks are currently suffering. In a big way, unfortunately. The tank just can't do anything when it has to stand up to the awesome power of something like the Eradicators. Right, so I think if I clip these bits out, we should be okay. Rest on the thing. What if we bring a pure Land Raider army to Warhipster Fest? Instant win. Yeah. You just get 100 points for every game. Your opponent must concede. Which under Chapter 2 and through 2020 actually would only give you 70 points. It's a little bit rough, but it's fine. Oh, I need the eagle's head as well. That will make sense. There it is, bit 34. Oh, that's very cool. That's very nice of you, Lithy. I've got a lot of Thousand Suns content to do. That's going to be coming very soon. Probably alongside the new Eldar stuff, as well as a few more Grey Knights pieces. So I've got Strike Marines, Purifiers, and a Dread Knight. Basically the rest of Hexfire left to do. Because we got Crow done, and we got the Infernal Master done. But I do have a Magnus, courtesy of Mr. Fort ADR Wargaming, aka 5 Minute 40k. Right, so that should just go like that. So let's get it on the... Let's get it on the turret bit first. Which is this bit here. So I've got Magnus, the Scarab Occult, and the Zangors, and a Zangor Shaman left to do, which I'll be doing alongside the Eldar. Just need for this bit to make sense, because that goes in there, and then this is going to go on top like that. Yeah, that'll do, won't it? So let's slather it. Well, you can tell we're running late. The music's completely gone.
A vortex beast.
Yeah. You're the second person to ask me to do that. Makes me think there might be a market. The Mutalith Vortex Beast. It's a very cool model. Gives me a flashback to my time as a Games Workshop manager, and someone came in asking if I stocked it, and I'd never heard of it at that point, so I was like, no. They're like, it's on your website. I was like, okay. So we ended up buying it from the web store, and it came in, and then it sat in my box, and no one came and got it. for a lot, which was a funny one. I just ended up with this Mutalith vortex piece for the rest of my life. Right, there we go. It's looking pretty good. It's not quite there. We've got one more cannon left to do and a couple of turrets, but the Land Raider meta is alive and well in Warhipster Towers in Cheltenham. Oh, love it. Love it so much. Right, I think that is where we are going to leave it for tonight. Thank you so much for hanging out. How much would it cost to have you paint the vortex beast in bright AF fluorescent pink? Quite a bit. Got my first bottle of Tamiya thin plastic glue. Is nice. Awesome, Tom Kennish. I might try it out. I might grab some. But yeah, I think we're going to end it there for now. Thank you so much for hanging out. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for the donation, Russ. That was very kind of you. And I look forward to bringing you a lot of Custodes content, including this Land Raider. Thank you for stopping by, Emily. I'm excited for Elden Ring. We should talk at some point. But yeah, thank you so much for being here. I will see you next time, next Wednesday, as per usual, with something else, I'm sure. Maybe we'll do some painting of some Custodes. Who knows? Well, we've also got a lot of Eldar content, so maybe we'll do some of that. For example, here is this magnetized Dire Avenger I built today. yeah. See you next week. Same Warhipster time, same Warhipster channel. I hope you all have a lovely week. Stay safe. And happy wargaming. See you around, guys. Ta-da for now!